President-elect Trump announced Tom Homan, the former acting director of Immigration and Customs Enforcement, who backed his zero tolerance policy, will be his administration's border czar. In a post on Truth Social, Trump wrote that Homan's areas of control will include the southern and northern borders, all maritime and aviation security. Trump added, border czar Homan will be in charge of the deportation of illegal immigrants. Homan touts hardline immigration views and previously vowed to run the biggest deportation force this country has ever seen.
So Zanny, obviously, this is going to be a big part of what Donald Trump likely does at the beginning of his administration. He promised mass deportations, historic deportations. The American people heard it every day for about a year and a half and voted for him. So this is going to be one of the first things. And I would guess one of the great challenges would be politically for this possible director to avoid the sort of chaos we saw at the beginning of his first term, where those first three, 4 days were just pictures of airports and other places just absolutely jammed with people, with protests, with chaos.
We have seen one estimate that says it would cost $88 billion to deport a million people a year.
I don't know if that's accurate or not.
Is that what American taxpayers should expect?
What price do you put on national security? Is that worth it?
Is there a way to carry out mass deportation without separating families?
Of course there is. Families can be deported together.
President-elect Trump's new cabinet is starting to take shape because overnight, while you were sleeping, he tapped Tom Homan to be his border czar.
Trump saying, quote, there is nobody better at policing and controlling our borders. Likewise, Tom Homan will be in charge of all deportation of illegal aliens back to their country of origin.
He worked with the president to come up with this job description. So let's hear from him in his first interview after the major announcement, incoming border czar Tom Homan. Tom, congratulations to you. It's bad for us. We lose you as a contributor. What went into the decision and the position?
Well, look, I've been on this network 4 years complaining about what this administration did to this border. I've been yelling and screaming about it, telling them what they need to do to fix it. So when the president asked me, would you come back and fix it? Of course I have to. I'd be a hypocrite if I didn't. So, look, I'm honored the president asked me to come back and help solve this national security crisis. So I'm looking forward to it. And, look, I love Fox. I love the family there. But I think that the calling is clear. I got to go back and help because every morning I'm pissed off about what this administration did to the most secure border in my lifetime. So I'm going to go back and do what I can to fix it.
What's up, y'all? Gerald here, creator of Gospel Chops and your host for this YouTube channel, back with another video. And yo, I went to grad school in the Midwest, right? With a lot of very smart people whom I respect to this day, sat in classrooms with these folks, heard them articulate their ideas, and I said, whoa, she's smart. He's incredible. This dude got a medical degree before he came to law school. Now he's going for his JD. These people are uber intelligent. At times I would think, what am I doing here? But you know what? When it comes to political opinions and political perspectives, y'all, these folks are liberals and diametrically opposed to my opinions on politics. So that is where we clash. And even though I applaud them getting the corner office and getting hired to a new firm in New York City, great on you, but I still disagree with your politics. Well, y'all, I would like to reach out to some of my friends who I'm still connected to on social media and say, it's going to be okay. But in the wake of this presidential election for 2024, I would be a liar if I said such things because I know they are fully bought into the leftist agenda, to the fascist agenda. And what is coming? Oh, my goodness, y'all. Donald Trump is putting his cabinet together. And as it begins to take shape, oh, what a shapely cabinet it's going to be. It's going to be shaped like a Coke bottle. it's going to be shapely enough to make every proud American turn heads and break necks. It's going to be incredible. Y'all, he just named Tom Homan as his border czar. And I put it in quotes because we don't even know what that is. Because Kamala was the border czar. They tried to deny it later on once she started running, but we knew. They called it years ago and said this woman was the border czar. This was her assignment. They never defined it, but it was her assignment. Bars, y'all. But now we got somebody in there who was the former head of ICE, Tom Homan. Y'all, I've never seen this man smile. He's always a very serious person. He's always angry and aggressive. He talks like he got a mouth full of snuff. Sometimes it's hard to understand what he's saying because of the way he speaks, but when he gets his point across, oh my goodness, is it ever across?
You were saying that. I wish somebody in Democratic leadership would say that out loud. Look, you want to know why there's 50,000 people in detention? You want to know why we have 1 million illegal entries in the United States? You want to know why we have these issues? Because you have failed to secure the border. You have failed to work with this president to close the three loopholes we've asked for 2 years to close. So if you want to know why this issue exists, you need to look in the mirror. You have failed American people for not securing the border and closing loopholes.
Mr. Homan, look, please respect the chair and the authority of the chair. The time of the gentleman has expired.
I've asked you politely to let me go beyond my time, and you let other people go beyond their time, but not to Tom Homan. He don't get me go beyond his time.
Mr. Homan, we have approved an agreement between the Republicans and the Democrats with the ranking member. We increased the time of one member of Congress who was interrupted by a protest. That is done with the approval of the ranking member. Please respect the chair's authority. The gentleman,
I respect the chair's authority, but the chair,
Mr. Homan,
you work for me. I'm a taxpayer. You work for me.
The witness will suspend.
It says the official recommendation. There were three different options presented. The third included the option for family separation. This initiative would pursue prosecution of all amenable adults, including those presenting with a family unit. Mr. Homan, your name is on this. Is this correct?
Yes, I signed that memo.
So you are the author of the family separation policy?
I am not the author of this memo.
You're not the author, but you signed the memo.
Yes, a zero tolerance memo.
So you provided the official recommendation to Secretary Nielsen on family, for the United States to pursue family separation.
I gave Secretary Nielsen numerous recommendations on how to secure the border and save lives.
But it says here that you gave her numerous options, but the recommendation was option three, family separation.
What I'm saying, this is not the only paper where we've given the Secretary numerous options to secure the border and save lives.
And so the recommendation, of the many that you recommended family separation.
I recommended zero tolerance,
which includes family separation.
The same as is with every U.S. citizen parent gets arrested when they're with a child.
Zero tolerance was interpreted as the policy that separated children from their
family. If I get arrested for DUI and I have a young child in a car, I'm going to be separated. When I was a police officer in New York and I arrested a father for domestic violence, I separated that
father from his family. Mr. Homan, with all due respect, legal asylees are not charged with any crime.
When you're in the country illegally, it's violation 8 United States Code 1325.
Seeking asylum is legal.
If you want to seek asylum, you go through the port of entry, do it the legal way. The Attorney General of the United States has made that clear.
Okay.
Talk about this now. Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez was out stumping for Bernie Sanders in Iowa. Let's take a listen to what she had to say on Saturday.
Organizing is about tipping people off if you start to see that ICE and CBP are in communities to try to keep people safe. I'm here because Senator Sanders has actually committed to breaking up ICE and CBP.
Tom, your thoughts on that statement?
It's ridiculous. It's an extremely stupid statement made by somebody I never considered real smart anyways. But here's an elected lawmaker. She's a congresswoman standing on a stage telling people how to obstruct ICE. tipping off people that ICE is looking for. And she needs to realize 9 out of 10 of everybody ICE arrested last year was a convicted criminal or pending criminal charges. Let me talk about a few. Last year, 137,000 criminals, 2,000 were murders, 12,000 sex offenses, 45,000 assaults, 62,000 drug offenses, 10,000 weapons offenses. And she wants the community to tip these people off. The ICE is in their neighborhood operating. It's, you know, ICE's job is already extremely dangerous. Now she's making it more dangerous. You know, and she's one of these Democrats keeps saying, no one's above the law. The president is above the law. We need to impeach the president because he's not above the law. But apparently illegal aliens are above the law because ICE isn't allowed to arrest them. It's a ridiculous statement.
Tom Homan.
It's
thanks
a
so
dangerous
much.
Statement.
Yeah. Tom, thanks for joining us. We appreciate it.
I got a message. As a guy who spent 34 years deporting illegal aliens, I got a message to the millions of illegal aliens that Joe Biden's released in our country in violation of federal law. You better start packing now. You're damn right. Because you're going home. I got another message. Another message to the criminal cartels in Mexico. You smuggled enough fentanyl across this country to kill 148,000 young Americans. You have killed more Americans than every terrorist organization in the world combined. And that's when President Trump gets back in office. He's going to designate you a terrorist organization, and he's going to wipe you off the face of the earth. You're done. You're done.
Now, this is where you're going to run into problems, see, because Tom Homan don't care about your excuses. No, he cares about the border. He cares about American security. He cares about the things that the average American cares about. And y'all, over the last few years, have let all these people in over the border by the millions and millions. Some estimate tens of millions just over the last few years under the Biden-Harris administration. Y'all, this man is finna get in here and roll some things back. And it's going to be unfortunate for some people, and he not trying to hear your excuses. This is why it's important to understand the mentality of a Tom Homan. You're going to say, well, you had a baby on American soil. That's your problem. Well, you spent so much money to get here. That's your problem. Well, I thought I was going to get amnesty. That's your problem. Well, I applied for DACA. That's your problem. Tom Homan don't care about none of that, y'all. He don't care how you feel about it. He don't care what you think about it. He don't care what kind of policies that these AOCs and Jayapals try to argue for to try to stifle his intentions. Y'all, he finna get in here and get to work. This is the kind of man who's going to get his hands dirty. And why? Because he understands the importance of American security. If you don't have a border, you don't have a country. And here you are, y'all. These people who claim to be so family-oriented at this point are the same people who advocated for the deletion of the unborn. No, you ain't for no family if you advocating for that. No. And what about these over 300,000 children that y'all have let into this country over the border illegally and have lost track of? We don't know where they at. Ain't no paperwork, ain't no ankle bracelet, ain't no tracking device, ain't nothing. We don't know where they are, y'all. Well, we do know where they are, right? Let's just be honest. Between you and I, we know where they are. They're being sex trafficked. They're being sold off. They locked in somebody's basement somewhere, chained to a radiator. Some of them are even unalived. Over 300,000 missing youth, children, illegal aliens brought across the border mostly by people who weren't even their parents. Who said, I'm carrying this baby. This is my baby. You got to let me in, America. I saw a video where they asked one man, well, what is the baby's birthday? What year was he born? He said 2023. Mind you, the question was asked in 2023. This baby looked like they were about 4 years old. This man is carrying a baby whom he does not know. This is not his child. He has no emotional connection to this child. He sees this baby, this innocent baby, as his ticket to enter the United States. So he'll carry this baby as far as he has to carry him to get in. And then once he's in, that ain't my baby. And America has no tracking system to keep track of the baby, and the baby is lost. Y'all, to the tune of 300,000. Well, if that hits you in the heart like it hits me in the heart, you should feel good about the fact that Mr. Homan, former head of ICE, is about to turn this country around and put us on a corrective track to get some of these lawbreakers out of our country. See, they want to say, well, we should start with the criminals first. Well, if you cross the border illegally, by definition, you are a criminal. Let's start with you, whomever you might be.
Let's talk about the job, because you're not an amateur. You've been doing this for years. You were a big cop. Also, you worked the border before, went over to ICE. You've done it all. What does the process look like? Because I think some people get the impression that you're shooting from your hip, but you know what you're doing here, right?
I know exactly what I'm doing. And look, this is the second time I came out of retirement for this president. And because it matters. And look, I was a Border Patrol agent. I wore that uniform, and I'm proud that I wore that uniform. So, and I was an ICE agent. I was the first ICE director that actually came up through the ranks. So the 20,000 men and women that worked for me, I didn't ask them to do anything. I'd do myself. I was one of them. So look, I know the border, and I know there's a lot of great patriots. Look, I shut my phone off Friday night because I couldn't handle the phone calls, the texts, and emails from thousands of ICE agents and Border Patrol agents excited about the rumor I'm coming back. But more importantly, that thousands of retired agents, retired Border Patrol agents, retired military that want to come in and volunteer to help this president secure the border and do the deportation operation. So I've been off the grid for 3 days just because I couldn't handle all the phone calls. And plus, all the death threats rolling in. My family's not at home right now because that's starting. But, you know, that's something we're going to deal with. They're not going to bully me away. They're not going to shut me up. And they're not going to make me go away. This is the biggest national security vulnerability this nation has seen since 9/11. We have to fix it.
And it's one of the reasons Kamala Harris lost and Donald Trump won. So Tom, you just mentioned deportations. I know during the last Trump administration, when you were there, they did have the large-scale worksite raids where they would go into a place and there would be hundreds of people who were in the country illegally. I know on 60 Minutes, a couple of weeks ago, you said that those would continue under Donald Trump in the next administration. What do you have planned? Well, I know you don't want to give away the whole game book, but you do have deportations, mass workplace stuff planned, any other kind of category of deportations of interest?
Look, as the president said on stage many times, which I agree with 100%, it's going to be the same it was during the first administration, which is just a hell of a lot more of them because 10 million people have entered this country illegally under the Biden administration, or they actually let into this country, even though it's a violation of federal law, what they've been doing, the abuse of the parole authority. But look, I've been clear, President Trump's been clear. Public safety threats and national security threats will be the priority, because they have to be. They pose the most danger to this country. So we're going to prioritize those groups, those who always have final orders, those that had due process at great taxpayer expense, and a federal judge says you must go home, and they didn't. They became a fugitive. So, and as far as worksite, worksite operations have to happen. Here's why, Steve. Where do we find most victims of sex trafficking and forced labor trafficking? At work sites. And the Biden administration shut down work sites. On one point, they say we care about sex trafficking and human trafficking. Then they shut down work site enforcement, which is one of the main areas we find the victims.
For years, y'all, we have been operating under policies that have put our Border Patrol at risk, that have put our ICE agents at risk, that have even put our local police at risk. And although I want to reach out to my former classmates and give them a hug, these smart liberals that I love and respect, I think they're wrong on this. And I know there's going to be a lot of tears shed because American policy is about to shift. Y'all, there's a shifting taking place. Y'all know how we say it in church. There's a shifting. taking place in American policy. And Donald Trump, as he puts his cabinet together, we are going to see the continuance of this shift back towards sanity, back towards a place where Americans were proud of their country, saluted the flag, said the Pledge of Allegiance, prayed in school, all those things. Bring it back. Let's bring back a nation of sanity, because we've gotten so far off the rails under these liberals, under these leftist fascists that would tell you that your son is now your daughter just because they say so. But when your son comes to you as a two-year-old and says, "Daddy, I'm a dinosaur," or "Daddy, I'm a superhero," and you say, "No, that's not realistic, that's just your imagination," well, they're okay with that. But you bet not dare tell your son that comes to you and say, "Daddy, I think I'm a girl." You bet not reject it. Not here in my state of California. Y'all, we're entering a new phase. We prayed for this. We touched and we agreed. We was here on this internet. We were communing and praying in unison and agreeing to beseech God for the things that we thought were in the best interest of America. So don't fret. Don't get scared. Don't be afraid when you see these things taking shape. This is what we asked for. Some of us are going to get what we asked for, and some of us on that other side are going to get something that they never could have imagined, because they bought into lies. They convinced themselves that the lies were truth. They convinced themselves that up was down and down was up. They convinced themselves that boys were girls and girls were boys. And now that the truth is going to be implemented by force, because y'all wouldn't take it no other way. See, sometimes you gotta force folks to take their medicine. Sometimes you gotta force folks to eat their peas. Oh, yes. America is about to eat its peas, y'all. And I'm glad about it. I hope and I pray that it will set us on a corrective path that will get us back to some sense of normalcy, some sense of familial commitment, some sense of honor and respect for the American flag and all those who fought for it on this Veterans Day, y'all. To all the veterans out there, thank you for your service. We appreciate you so much. I know you have suffered mentally over the last few years as you have watched your country deteriorate. Oh, but there's a remnant. He may not be God's man, but God has his hand on the situation and he's using that man. Y'all parse it how you want. But there's going to be a change that is coming. And Donald Trump has a little over, I believe, 70 days or so to get this thing together. And there are some things that are taking place, y'all, with Tom Homan. Oh boy, there is a reckoning that is coming. There is a reset button that's about to be pushed in this country, and I'm glad about it. I hope that you are too. And let me know in the comments if you are or if you aren't. I'd love to know your thoughts on this topic. And don't forget to like the video, subscribe to the channel, and share the video so we can get more people involved in the conversation, y'all. And like I always say, always remember and never forget, without the gospel, it's just chops. Until next time, peace.